Hampshire Regional Cop Blog. This is a bike week, and I found cops. Jumping back to the 90s. Jumping off Biggie. Tell all the viewers. Yeah, right here. Man. This goes to about 1 mile by 1 mile. From a college? Okay. All right, be a coward. That's okay. Thank you.
Too bad you can't save their face. You gotta wait for their right away.
What, you want to be a fucking coward too? Or are you going to answer my questions too? Are they from a university?
They're University of Hampshire.
Oh, okay. I do say it to their face. 400 videos to prove it. Oh, big hero on the internet. Why don't you meet me in Fallujah in 2004 and go talk to somebody else, okay? All right?
You're talking to
you. With your stupid-ass fucking characterizations. All right?
You said you
like
what?
I was asking him, and he blatantly ignored me. Well, you guys are insulting just by standing here.
I'm already standing here just like you do.
No, you don't.
How do you figure?
Because you make a vow to fight crime, not sit here and watch a bar have people having fun. Get the highest rate of freaking overdose in the whole county. Go deal with it.
Am I bothering anybody? No. I'm watching for drugs.
You're watching for drugs. Okay. This lady right here is watching for drugs. Now, if he was nice to me, I would have showed him the same respect. No, you didn't. You said it's too bad you want to say that when he's going on.
Come here.
Am I a perfectly nice person?
Oh, you are a perfectly nice person.
Perfectly nice person, right?
What?
I'm being accused of not being a nice person.
Very strange. It just stinks. I guarantee the city has a problem with this bar.
No, actually, the owner's a very nice guy. If you want, he's out the door. The guy with the mustache, the curly hair, asked us if he was taking a threat. You go talk to him. I highly encourage it.
So is he hiring you guys to stand there?
Brett Loring.
So he's a cop lover then?
Well, I don't know about that. He's a supporter and he wants his business protected, right? Some people want their... put his whole life and his life savings in that place. He wants to protect him.
Is it a cop a bar? A lot of police go there?
No, actually, you don't help people. If you went in, you can go take a look for yourself.
Wiretapping, can't go into a private building.
Oh, okay.
What's your name, man?
I'm Detective Neary.
JP from the Hampshire Regional Cop Block.
Hi.
Not a free state. Decentralized, so
okay.
You might be part of poplar.org, which is the
gotcha.
National site,
okay.
But then there's no correlation.
Okay.
Actually, I don't like it.
I've met him a few times, yeah. So I'm not real sure of the structure of how.
But I'm not trying to antagonize. I just don't want to be ignored.
I have a motor on mine.
The pet peeve thing.
I think, you know, the guys from the university.
They're not used to.
They're good at crowd control and management if something gets out of hand, but they're not used to...
Public?
Yeah, not necessarily public, but a different kind of public.
Yeah, I usually do Keene State every year.
Yep.
And that's what I'm known for. So the university have actual cops?
Yes, they do. Yep. Them and for the state. And I mean, you're absolutely right about the drug problem. Holy crap.
That's one of the many things I don't agree with the Free State is with. I do believe it causes victims, man. Heroin destroys communities.
And I don't know what the answer is, you know, as far as how you combat this thing.
You have to do it community style, not combat style.
I agree.
And unfortunately, cops are being trained combative.
We actually have that program where we have an officer that's a prevention and training officer, so he's...
Yeah, but it should be implemented in every cop.
Oh, I agree.
Instead of being trained to react first, they need to be community oriented first.
And
that's the biggest problem with policing, especially in the country now where, you know, everybody wants to...
And I don't disagree with that.
I mean, cops are trained to be... They're trained to automatically think there's a danger before there's even a danger.
And in order to restructure that, you've got to start from the top down, you know, the chiefs and the things. And not even that, but, you know, city councils and things like that.
Yeah.
I absolutely agree. And I don't know what the answer is or how to keep you all on the same page and combat that sort of thing. And I see it getting worse.
It's going to need something like Ferguson to blow up before people stop paying attention to it. I don't think we should be spending a ton of money on, you know, rhino delivery vehicles that are, you know, an aftermath of the war in Iraq, and then give them to you guys, and now you guys look like SEAL Team 6 when you break down somebody's door. I think the squat and all that stuff in the circus needs to stop. Catch them out on the street doing something in the public. Always been the best way to do shit. Breaking down doors is just gonna hurt other people and yourself. Scary business, man.
It is.
Yeah, Ademo used to live here.
He did, yeah.
I forgot about that. I forgot Ademo lived in Laconia for a while with Kate.
Yeah, it wasn't too long, maybe a year or less.
Yeah, I'm only up here for an hour. I was supposed to be here for 3 days, but... No. No. He was... took a rest.
You know, every talk is different. I'm not here to bother these folks after this time. I don't, you know... I've been doing this too long.
I've seen situations turn in seconds.
Oh, sure.
Fight break out. So this is basically a Hell's Angel mob.
Sure.
Predominantly.
I hesitate to characterize them for the Hell's Angel, but it's what they're saying to hang out with our team. Yeah.
Alright.
So there are quite a few of them in there, and we do have a clubhouse in Laconia that has Hell's Angels. Hell's Angels clubhouse, but they're obviously more active than Vikings, so this is the roadhouse is just dependent across the way down the street. So I think it's their favorite hangout for bike people. I don't know how it became that way, but as long as I've been here, it's the way it's been.
So what do you do, crime against children or vice?
Actually, I'm a narcotics detective.
Okay.
Hey, you know, it hits home when you talk about, you know, go do something about the drug problem. It's like, man, you know, I'm drowning. And like I said, I don't know what the answers are.
Albuquerque, New Mexico, and arrested all those cops last summer. I'm really sorry, but my voice is blowing out. It's shot. I usually sound a little bit more deeper than him. But there's a lot of action here, man.